Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is meant by Gerber's criteria. Now this Gerber's criteria is used in case of design and it is one of the simplest methods. Here Gerber's criteria can be understood that it is a graph of variable stress sigma v versus mean stress sigma m. So it is basically a graph of variable stress versus mean stress. And on this graph, we have the stresses on the positive x-axis as tensile and the negative x-axis as compressive stress. Now, here as we can see, there is a Gerber parabola. Here we are having a Gerber parabola. And these points which are closer to the parabola are called as the failure points, because when the element was subjected to some kind of load, it has failed and that stress values are plotted. And it has come closer to the Gerber parabola. Now, as these lines are scattered, we are going to modify the system, and that modification is in the form of Goodman line and Soderberg line, which are straight lines. That is, instead of parabola, these are the straight lines. If we are joining the sigma e value, which is called as the endurance stress, to the ultimate stress, then it is called as Goodman line. And if sigma e is connected to sigma y, which is called as yield stress, that is called as Soderberg line. Now, once we have understood this graph, next I can say that I can write the formula that according to Gerber, variable stress is given by, now according to Gerber, the variable stress, it can be written as sigma v is equal to sigma e into 1 upon factor of safety minus sigma m upon sigma u whole square into factor of safety, and then it can be simplified keeping factor of safety on one side. So sigma v upon sigma e is equal to 1 upon FOS minus sigma m upon sigma u whole square FOS. I'll keep 1 upon FOS on one side. So 1 upon FOS is equal to sigma V upon sigma E plus sigma M upon sigma U whole square FOS. So now this is the equation of Gerber's criteria. And here we have sigma v as variable stress, sigma e as endurance limit stress, or we can say endurance stress, sigma m is mean stress, sigma u ultimate stress, and FOS is the factor of safety. Now the Gerber equation which I have written here, this is neglecting stress concentration factor. Now when we are considering stress concentration factor, then the equation becomes 1 upon FOS is equal to sigma v into k suffix f upon sigma e plus sigma m upon sigma u whole square into FOS. So now I can say that this equation, it is Gerber's equation considering stress concentration factor, and here I can define the terms where sigma v is equal to variable stress, k suffix f is equal to fatigue factor for stress concentration. Next, sigma e is equal to endurance limit stress. Then sigma m is equal to mean stress. And next, sigma u is equal to ultimate stress. and here we have FOS as the factor of safety. And all the stress values, they have a unit of Newton per mm square. So here in this video we have seen the Gerber's criteria, that is, it is actually a parabola on that parabola the points which are closer to that are the failure points, that is the object which was subjected to some kind of loading. When it has failed, it has come closer to the Gerber parabola, and if it is simplified, then we get two lines which are Goodman line and Soderberg line. Goodman line considers yield ultimate stress, whereas Soderberg line considers yield stress. And here is the parabola, which is the Gerber parabola, and we have seen its two equation. First, which was neglecting the stress concentration factor, and the second equation we have seen considering the stress concentration factor. And with this, we complete this concept.